కొన్నిసార్లు ఏంటంటే బై మిస్టేక్ మనం ముందు గాని వెనక్కి గాని ఓపెన్ చేస్తే మాత్రం అంటే ఎగ్జాక్ట్ గా స్టార్టింగ్ టైం ఎగ్జాక్ట్ కాకుండా చేస్తే అప్పుడు మనం చేసుకోవాల్సి వస్తుంది కొన్నిసార్లు.
ఓకే అర్థమైంది అర్థమైంది. ఆ ఫోన్ చేసాను స్టార్ట్ చేసాను ఒకసారి చూడమనండి. ఒకసారి
సార్ రికార్డ్
అవుతుందో. ఓకే సో జస్ట్ టుడే వి హావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ ద మినరల్ ఆయిల్స్ అండ్ ఆల్్రెడీ ఐ టోల్డ్ యు ద మినరల్ ఆయిల్స్ కెనాట్ బి యూస్డ్ అట్ ఎలివేటెడ్ టెంపరేచర్స్. That is paraffin hydrocarbons, and they'll break the thin film at excessive high temperatures. That's why we have to use the mineral oils. So the compounded form means the mineral oils are mixed with fatty oils and acids. Fatty oils and acids, and one of the example of the mineral oils is compounded mineral oils, is sulfurized mineral oils. Sulfurized mineral oils. Yesterday. We have just and these are known as the compounded mineral oils, where they are mixed with the good lubricant that has sulfurized mineral oil. It is used for machining of tough low carbon steels. Already example I have given yesterday. Just we are revising, so because people only 76 people have joined up to now, and this particular. Sulfurized mineral oil is a very good lubricant under extreme high pressure. That's why it's known as EP lubricant, and they can be used in excessive friction, as in drawing, deep drawing or wide drawing, grinding, extrusion, and forming. In the metal working process or the metal forming processes. So again, we have the other types of oils. That is the compounded mineral oils. These oils are compounded with chlorine. They're known as chlorinated compounds. Chlorinated compounds, and use of this particular chlorinated compounds in metal cutting or metal machining, it promotes the anti-weld characteristics. Anti-weld means the particular chip will not will not stick to the particular tool because it will prevent the problems of built-up edge. It prevents the problems of built-up edge. So you have to give some examples like this. As far as the presentation is concerned, and this is a just off-topic. It is in the syllabus, but some may feel it is bored and try to just leave. But is asking in some of the particular big questions. So next one, we have the waxes. So in the particular lubricants. We have the waxes, and these waxes are generally derived from, already I told you, from petroleum, fractional distillation of petroleum. We might have studied in chemistry, and these are the particular used in rolling, drawing, and tinning. Tinning means you can use that in the tinning process, where it is a type of surface coating, you can say. Mostly it is in some of the automobile industries for some models like Kinetic Honda, we try to use the particular tinning process. So various waxes, what are the various waxes? It include the paraffin wax, natural bee wax, etc. But when these waxes are compounded, again we have to go for compounding. Whenever we have to use that particular lubricant at elevated temperatures, we can use them with fatty acids and soap under high pressures. Whenever we want to use that particular lubricant at elevated temperature and high pressures, because at elevated temperature the friction will be more, and you have to use the waxes compounded with fatty acids and soap. So all these are the particular lubricants which we have to take into consideration. And the next one, the waxes we have finished, and I think we have come to this last type in the types of lubricants. And we have the, yesterday we have discussed the graphite suspensions also. So what are the graphite suspensions? Graphite suspensions are made by mixing of simply graphite powder in oil or water. Mostly use oil, and for some other purposes we use water, but water we use only for not less temperature, not elevated temperatures. At elevated temperatures we try to use oil, and this particular graphite suspensions are used in forging, boundary works, extrusion, wire drawing, etc. So we'll try to go to the new share. That is, we'll try to go for the economics of metal cutting. Economics of metal cutting. So all these are very important aspects we have to see. And in the economics of metal cutting, we'll just try to discuss the important things as far as the economics of metal cutting is concerned. So this is nothing but in the economics of metal cutting, we have the why we have to go for economics. Why we have to opt for economics? That you have to see. So because if you are offering, you are manufacturing a particular product, and you are selling it at not an acceptable price to the market or to the particular customer, because you want to earn profit, you cannot, you have to justify a particular product. Though it is of higher quality, but your particular selling will not be there. It cannot be sold. So whatever product you manufacture in a machine shop, you have to see that the manufacturing cost of a product, you should keep it at a low price so that the product is acceptable in the market. So whenever more amount of products will be sold, then only you can earn more profit. Then only you can earn more profit. That is the particular thing you have to see. And we have to, in metal machining, what happens is attempts have been made in different ways. What you are doing is you are optimizing the tool life to minimize the production cost. Sairam, you can hear my voice? Sairam? CR?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So some problem with the earphones. Okay. So
yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. It is audible. Okay. So we have to optimize the tool life to minimize the production cost, or you have to maximize the production rate to lower down the production cost. So all these are definite things you have to take into consideration. But what happens if you want to increase? Some people think that by decreasing the cutting speed, you can increase the tool life. But what happens? The metal removal rate is reduced. So whatever metal removal rate you want to go for it, you cannot achieve that particular MRR, metal removal rate. But what happens if the particular cutting speed is increased? Cutting speed is increased means the particular tool life will be reduced drastically. Tool life will be reduced drastically. So that is the particular thing you will be observing. And at the same time, the tool cost also will be increased because you have to replace the tool because of tool wear. The tool life will be reduced and you have to replace the tool in a smaller period of time. That is, you know, the particular tool life definition. So you have to go for more amount of regrinding, resharpening of the tool when the tool is new and in between. So you have to replace the tool. Just like a chalk piece you are writing on the blackboard, we are using much in as far as problems or any theory. We want to just exhibit that particular whatever you want to tell to the students. It will be becoming a length. The length of the chalk piece will be decreasing like that. So chalk piece you cannot resharpen. Only you have to replace with a new chalk piece. Just like that. Tool, if it is getting blunt because of the higher cutting speed, you have to go for resharpening of the tool. So what you have to do, you have to strike a balance. You have to strike a balance between the optimum cutting speed and the cost. So you have to go for the optimum cutting speed, and you have to see the economics also. Economical tool life. So economical tool life means it will ensure an economical production, because if you are trying to increase the cutting speed beyond a optimum level also, the surface finish on the workpiece will be affected. Some particular tool marks or scratch marks or some tear marks will come. We'll just try to discuss in metrology subject that one. And you cannot achieve the particular dimensions also may be affected because of the thermal stress, excessive heat that is generated between the tool and the workpiece. So that is the things we have to consider. So we have to balance the particular optimum cutting speed to corresponding to the economical tool life, which will result in an economical production. So all these things are part and parcel. So all who is the person behind this particular economics of metal machining? You have to know, because just like F.W. Taylor in industrial engineering management is a pioneer of the particular IEM, industrial engineering management. Like that, we have W.W. Gilbert. He has evaluated tool life for for minimum cost per piece, and second one, maximum production rate. Minimum cost per piece and maximum production rate. So that is very important. Today, mostly, we'll be just discussing the first part only. And tomorrow, if there are any problems, we'll try to discuss. I have one problem, one particular metal cutting problem or orthogonal cutting problem left over with me. That is eight problem. We'll just try to complete if time permits today. But you have to know this concept of economics of metal machining. So what we have to do, the minimum cost per piece. So what you are doing, the total production cost of a product per piece will consist of the following things. So the machining cost per piece, first one, how much we have to per piece, what is the machining cost, what is the tool changing cost, because in between you don't use only one tool, there are number of tools in the tool turret. In the tool turret, in the hexagonal turret, there are six tools. There are, in an octagonal turret, we have eight tools. And then the turret layer, we have a particular turret which can handle up to 14 tools at a time. So because of the number of operations for a particular workpiece to come out of the machine shop, you have to use a number of tools, just like a turning tool, facing tool, knurling tool, threading tool, taper turning. All these particular tools are there. So the external thread and internal thread also, all that particular, the boring, reaming, all that particular things, drilling tools. So total tool grinding cost per piece, tool changing cost per piece is the second one. Third one is the tool grinding cost per piece. So what is the fourth one? The ideal cost or non-production cost. So whenever a machine is idle, it is known as the non-production cost per piece, because it is also, we'll have to take into the consideration, because the time lost in replacing and regrinding, in replacing one tool with another, or you try to take out the blunt tool and try to go for resharpening, or you just have to have a secondary tool ready with you. Though we have a secondary tool with you, the total, the time that is used in machine setting or keeping that in the particular tool turret, the hexagonal turret, it will take time. So that's why you have, and the ideal cost also, here we have that particular, any worn out tools we have, the loading and unloading of the workpiece is also ideal cost, because that is the non-production cost. All this we have to take into consideration. So what is, so in order to evaluate the minimum cost per piece, the total production cost of a product per piece you have to see. That is the machining cost per piece, tool changing cost per piece, tool grinding cost per piece. Per piece, you just have to see the word per piece, we have to see. So if it is per piece, then you have to calculate per shift how many, suppose 1000 into that particular cost per piece. So that is the particular things we have to see, and slowly we'll be moving to the particular the terminology what we'll be using in this minimum cost per piece. So you just try to observe what is K1. What is K1? K1 is nothing but it is the direct labor cost. Direct labor cost plus overhead charges. Overhead charges are varying. So you just try to, don't try to specify the overhead charges. And the next one, K2, is nothing but it is the cost of tool per grind. Cost of tool. Cost, you know, it is only given in rupees, not in paise. So L is equal to length of machining. So what is the length you have taken into consideration while going for machining? So what is D? D is the diameter of workpiece. diameter of workpiece machined mm. So all that you have to take into consideration. V is the cutting speed in orthogonal cutting, or the other problems we have seen in tool life problems also, the cutting speed is given in meters per minute or mm per minute, and feed rate is given by mm per revolution, mm per revolution. So all the other things you have to see. And what is ideal time? Ideal time is TI, T subscript I. So you just try to the taken PDF, taken photo. It is not TI, T subscript I. You know what is subscript and superscript? By now you have to know, because in you are a mechanical engineer. Don't say don't know anything about MS Word or Excel something. So TC, T subscript C, tool changing time in minutes. So what is the tool changing time in minutes also you have to consider. So all these are the notations which we use in the subsequent. So you can say it is a derivation or a formula which we have to extract. So by combining all the parameters A, B, C, A plus B plus C plus D. So all that, so what is the machining cost per piece? The first one is direct labor cost plus overheads into machining time per piece. But what is the machining time per piece? Already you know, in some of the in mostly in metal cutting or any of the particular, because you have just finished the foundry for forming and welding. So this is the second part of the manufacturing subject. So machining time per piece is length of machining L by feed rate into RPM. So it is capital L by F into N, where F is the feed rate and N is the, what is N? N is the revolutions per minute. So it is a spindle when it is rotated in a definite RPM. So in turning operations, especially in lathe, what is V? V is equal to pi D N by 1000. So you have to express that in equation one, what is N? N can be written as 1000 into V by pi D. So that is the particular. So you have to put the value of N in this particular equation, in the particular equation, machining time per piece. So in machining time per piece, it is L by F into N. So instead of N, if you substitute the value of 1000 V by pi D, you arrive at this particular equation. Machining time per piece is equal to pi D L by F into V into 1000. You have to know all the parameters. D is the diameter of workpiece, L is the length of the machining, and F is speed, V is the cutting speed. So all that you have to consider, machining time per piece, pi DL by F into V into 1000, or pi DL by 1000 FV. So machining, that is into sign, it's not X. I have to put a dot, but it's not visible on the screen. That's why I've taken as into. So what is the machining cost per piece? The first line we have taken as K1. What is K1? It is the direct labor cost plus overhead charges. So into pi DL by 1000 FV, or F into V into 1000. That is the second equation. So this is the first part where we have evaluated or the particular formula regarding the machining cost per piece. Machining cost per piece. So what is the second part? It is the tool changing cost per piece. It is the tool changing cost per piece. So it is nothing but it is the direct cost plus overheads into tool failures per piece into tool changing time per piece. So you have to take into consideration both tool failures per piece and tool changing time per failure. So this particular parameters, and you know, every time I'm repeating the Taylor's tool life equation, V into T to the power of N is equal to C. N is the index, there is a then C is the constant, and N is the index or exponent. It depends upon the particular roughing operation or turning operation, and it depends upon the tool material. So upon rearranging the Taylor's tool life equation, VT power N is equal to C, we can take as T is equal to C to the power of 1 by N by V to the power of 1 by N. So here what you have to do, what is the total number of tool failures? You have to take that as Tx per piece. So what is the total number of tool failures Tx? So it is nothing but you have to take that as a ratio of machining time per piece by tool life. By tool life. That's why you have to preoccupy or before this particular TX, you have to calculate the T, that is the tool life, before this one, before this particular step. So what is the machining time per piece? You know what is the machining time per piece? Already we have seen machining time per piece is pi dl in the previous one, in the A part, the first part, pi dl by 1000 FV. By what is T? T is equal to, here we have calculated, you just try to see here, T is equal to C to the power of 1 by n by V to the power of 1 by n. So you have to substitute the machining time per piece, previously we have calculated here, pi dl by 1000 FV by the particular, okay, it's jumping. So it is nothing but, it is the pi dl by 1000 FV by the tool life, which is given by C to the power of n by V to the power of n. So we'll just come back because sometimes without mouse, it is just jumping. So just try to see that. So this is the particular equation. The third equation we have formed. You can give your own number, but convenience, I have given the equation number. So it is pi dl. You just try to see pi dl. So if you try to take this at the top, it is V to the power of 1 by n minus 1. Because this is minus 1. So 1000 F into C to the power of 1 by n. So just try to take this up. You'll get this equation. That is the, what is Tx? Already I told you, Tx is nothing but total number of tool failures per piece. Total number of tool failures per piece. So it is, so again, what is the tool changing cost per piece? You don't take total just because it is, don't strike. So I just put in bracket. Tool changing cost per piece is equal to K1 into, so what I told you, tool changing cost per piece is K1 into that particular Tx. So what is Tx? Already we have calculated. Tx is nothing but it is pi dl into V to the power of 1 by n minus 1 by 1000 F into C to the power of n by n into Tc. So what is Tc here? Already I told you. What is Tc? Can you hear me? Sairam? Sairam?
Yes, okay. Sir.
Okay. Tc is tool changing time. This is the tool changing time in minutes. So the second part, if you are calculating the tool changing cost per piece, the final equation is given by K1 into Tx. So what is Tx? We have to substitute the value of Tx in this one. And you are left over with this one into Tc. What is Tc? Already I told you in the beginning. What is tool changing cost per piece? It is direct cost plus overheads into tool failures per piece. Tool failures per piece is given by Tx and into tool changing time per failure. So what is tool changing time per failure in minutes? It is given as Tc. So the final equation you have to write like this. So K1 into Tx into Tc. Or we can write where Tx is equal to pi dl, this term, this particular term. So that is the particular things we have to consider. And what is tool grinding cost per piece? Tool grinding cost per piece. It is nothing but cost of tool per grind. It is nothing but, already I told you, it is taken as K2 in rupees into total number of tool failures per piece. So total number of, already we have arrived at this expression Tx in the second case, that is in B, case B. So what is the particular tool grinding cost per piece now? K2 into total number of tool failures per piece. We have arrived at pi dl into V to the power of 1 by n minus 1 by 1000 into F into C to the power of n. So C is the constant, F is the feed rate. D is the diameter of the workpiece or the job. L is the length of the machining, length of machining. And here, V is the cutting speed. So the fourth case. So what is the fourth case? Already I told you. It is nothing but, it is the ideal or non-productive cost per piece. The machine idle time. Because Why we are telling? Because if the machine is idle, we are not getting any production or any particular component out. So that is the particular thing. So it is direct labor cost plus overheads into idle time. Idle time is given by TI. So what is the idle cost per piece? It is nothing but K1 into TI. So what is K1? K1 is direct labor cost plus overhead charges. Direct labor cost plus overhead charges. So that is the particular, the fourth case, it is case D. We have taken the idle cost per piece as K1 into TI. K1 into TI. So what is the summation? What is the total production cost? So what is the total production cost is given by per piece? It is K. It is a summation of A. What is A? Machining cost per piece plus B. What is B? It is the tool changing cost per piece plus C. What is C? It is tool regrinding cost per piece plus D. So what is D? It is the ideal cost per piece. So you have to sum up all these things and arrive at the final equation where we have K is equal to K1 into K is equal to K1 into what is the into machining time per piece. This one is given by machining time per piece pi dl by 1000 FV plus K1 into second part plus K1 into TX. What is TX? It is the machining time per piece by tool life. This is machining time per piece into tool life. That's why you have got this particular machining time per piece and the particular tool life terms in the second part, that is B. So what is into TC? TC already I told you. You have to take that into consideration while taking the total tool changing cost per piece as direct cost plus overheads into tool failures. Tool failures is TX and tool changing cost, tool changing time per failure is given by TC. This is the tool changing time for failure. Plus K2. What is K2 here? It is the cost of tool per grind. Cost of tool per grind. That is the third one. Tool regrinding cost per piece. Into what you have to be taken here? Into total number of tool failures. This is TX. This is simply TX. So just try to observe the second and third term. In the second term, you have K1. In the third term, you have K2. But additionally, you have in this, you have to consider the tool failure here. Here also you have to consider, but this TC term is not there in the third one. Because TC is the, because the third one C is the tool regrinding cost. The second one is the tool changing cost per piece. This is the tool changing cost. And what is the fourth one? D. D is the ideal or non-productive cost per piece. So this is a very important thing, my dear friends. You'll be asking the derivation or the problem related to this one. You have to be very careful in projecting that particular terms, the exact terms, and you have to see that you have to present in a proper manner, all this one. So we'll try to go for the new share if it is possible now, and new share is there, but we have to open one of the particular thing. I think if it is open or not, I'll just try to see the PDF, and we just try to go for the things which are there here. So this is on the screen, but if it is, if we can minimize, we'll just try to see. And if you want to again repeat this particular slide again, I'll repeat so that it will be this one, it will be useful for you also. So I'll again repeat this particular thing so that we can go to the new topic tomorrow. New topic or one problem is left, we'll try to do and complete. Tomorrow we'll be completing the unit one, fundamentals of machining along with a problem. So next week we'll start the second unit, that is the lathe. So again, you try to observe these things. We have 15 minutes time, but it's not sufficient to go for a new problem. It is a big one and a new topic also. So just try to revise this particular, I already told you, you have to be very sincere in any subject. You have to be with along with your notebook calculator. You have to just don't listen like a burakada or some particular story. You have to practice. That's why I'm every time sharing the particular PPT or the things, the problems immediately after the class to the CRs, particular CRs, Section A and Section B CRs. So just try to see the concept of this one. It is the economics of metal machining. So already I told you why we have to go for economics of metal machining in order to avail the particular this one at an economical price. So just try to see these parameters again and try to see that the particular things are taken into consideration, the machining cost per piece and the tool changing cost per piece, the tool grinding cost per piece and the ideal cost. And the ideal cost. So all these are very important aspects of the economics of metal machining, and we have to take into consideration also. I already told you maximum production rate. So we have to have a draw a graph between the number of the cutting speed and total time per piece also, and you have to evaluate the total time also, and try to see that. At a lower cutting speeds, the production rate is also low. Lower cutting speeds, naturally the production rate is also low. But when the cutting speed is increased, production rate also increases. So up to a certain point, if you try to draw a graph between cutting speed and the total time per piece, you can understand. We'll just try to discuss tomorrow this one. And all this particular things you have to see, what is the particular maximum production rate also. You have to go for the optimum tool life equation as well as the optimum cutting speed equation also. So we'll just try to discuss in the next class that one. But before that, we just try to take this economics of metal machining. All these four cases you have to discuss along with the relevant notations. The relevant notations are standard. Don't try to change. These are from the standard textbooks. That is a metal cutting handbook where P.N. Rao or any particular author would have taken from them, but we have to explain it in a clear-cut manner. So K1 is equal to direct labor cost plus overhead charges. K2 is the cost of tool per grind in rupees. So, and L is length of machining, D is diameter of workpiece machine. You just try to see L and D, diameter of workpiece machine is told, not the raw workpiece. Not the fresh workpiece. You have to see that. And L is length of machining, not raw material length. So you have to take all that. So V is the cutting speed, meters per minute or mm per minute. F is the feed rate. So TI, ideal time. So all that particular things you have to take into consideration. The TC is the tool changing time. And you have to again calculate the machining cost per piece. Machining cost per piece is direct labor cost plus overheads into machining time per piece. Sometimes if you try to neglect the overheads, you can directly write that as that one. But overheads you cannot neglect. Some overheads will be there. Unforeseen kachilu antaru kada alaga overheads ante. So machining time per piece is length of machining by feed rate into RPM is equal to L by F into N, capital L. To take as capital L. So in turning operations, already you know cutting speed is given by 5 dBs. Just try to revise. So you have to substitute the value of N in this particular equation 1. So you will be getting that particular machining time per piece, and we have got that as 5 dBs by 1000 FP. If we try to substitute that in machining cost per piece, K1 into machining time per piece. K1, what is K1? Direct labor cost plus overhead charges. So this is the first case, that is case A, tool changing cost per piece. Don't talk among yourselves, my dear participants. Today I forgot to mute all. So tool changing cost per piece is direct cost plus overheads into tool failures per piece. Tool failures is given by, already I told you, it is TX in tool changing. Time per failure is given by TC. to tell us, you have to rewrite the Taylor's formulas equation in order to get the term in terms of T, tool failure in minutes. So all this total number of tool failures, already I told you, Tx, you have to take Ts is machining time per piece. Already you have calculated the machining time per piece in the previous case. Tool life T, you have rearranged form of C to the power of n by B to the power of 1 by n. So you have to be crystal clear. You have to take any topic, you have to solve each and every part from A to Z. Computations. And Tx is pi dl by 1000 at feet, and P is by 2 life. So if you can get the third equation, you can get the third equation. So what is the tool changing cost per piece? Tool changing cost per piece is k1 into pi dl particular equation we have substituted. This is Tx, k1 into Tx into Tc. What is Tx? Tx is the tool failures per piece. What is Tc? Tool changing time for failure. So all these things you have to keep in mind. Third case, you have to go for tool grinding cost per piece. So what is cost of tool per grind, K2, is known as K2, into total number of tool failures. Simply per piece, it is Tx. So total regrinding cost per piece is equal to K2 into Tx. Here you are not taking the tool changing, because here only you are going for tool regrinding. So this is K2 into Tx. So that is the third case. This is the third case. So ideal time or non-productive cost per piece is direct labor cost plus overheads into ideal time. So what is the ideal cost per piece? It is simply K1. What is K1? It is the direct labor cost plus overhead into Ti. So yeah, in order to get the total production cost per piece K, you have to sum up all the four cases, A plus B plus C plus D. There are four equations, whatever you have framed or before. And you have to go for K is equal to K1 into pi dl. K1 into machining time per piece plus K1 into Tx into Tc, where Tx is this particular term, pi dl, this particular term, into Tc, tool changing cost, plus K2 into Tx. What is Tx? Total number of tool failures per piece plus K1 into Ti. What is Ti? Ti is the ideal time. So all this you have to take into consideration. Till we have time, I'll refresh the cutting plates, and tomorrow we'll go for any miscellaneous topic that is left behind in the unit, or try to finish any untouched topic in this unit. Tomorrow is the last hour for unit 1, fundamentals of machining. Gopal Krishna garu. Jairam?
Sir.
Gopal Krishna garu lera?
Peru teliyadu sir, gaani evaro unnaru sir.
Yes, we Gopal Krishna garu. Okay. Kondaru waiting room
lo unnaru. Co-host unnam sir, peru.
Okay. Co-host. So, in the particular this one, we try to go for the cutting fluids also. So you just try to revise what we have just discussed yesterday. So just because 10 people are there, people just attendance or come for attendance based because already we have given you warning not to join late. That's why the course will be taken care of. Whatever actual attendance we have, we'll try to upload in the Google Sheet. So here, already I told you, yesterday, in the practice of cutting fluids, what we have discussed, what is the purpose of using cutting fluids, the second part, but what is a cutting fluid, what is the practice of a good cutting fluid, and we know what is the practice, already you know, and you should have the good lubricating property. For producing low coefficient of friction, the particular lubricant should not react chemically, it should be having high flash point in order to avoid the particular fires, fire accidents, fire hazards, all this are there. So, but yesterday we have not discussed some part. We'll be discussing though in the screen. It cannot be shown. So we have in the types of cutting fluids, active cutting oils. Active cutting oils are nothing but they are the oils which react chemically with the work surface to help in the machining operations. And the second part is the inactive cutting oils. Inactive cutting oils are nothing but, yesterday we discussed the state mineral oils or the compounded mineral oils which are sulfurized. What I told you, it is the sulfurized mineral oils or the chlorinated compounds. So this particular specifications for cutting oils are given by the Indian standard. Just for the knowledge sake, I am telling. As per the Indian standard 1115, long back they have framed 1973, but they might have just revised that particular thing. So what are the oils and compounds? I'll just try to hear me. So what are the oils and compounds we have to suggest for use of different metals and machining operations? What are the oils and compounds we have to go? So don't talk about among yourselves, lot of disturbance is there. Gopal Krishna sir. Chapman sir. So for low carbon steels for turning, we are using soluble oils. Yesterday we have discussed that also, soluble oils. We have the conventional emulsions which contain 80% of water, fatty acids, mineral oils and soap. So these are the soluble oils, the straight mineral oils already we have discussed yesterday. For drilling and milling, we use again soluble oils. For tapping, we use the active mineral oil. And for grinding, we use the soluble oil or the active type of mineral oil or the compounded mineral oils. We'll use them. And for broaching, we use again the active mineral oil or the soluble oil emulsion. The emulsions also you have to take into consideration, because most of the cutting and grinding involves the use of emulsions or emulsifiers. So we have the simple emulsions or the conventional emulsions and the compound emulsions. Compound, just like mineral oil and compound mineral oil, we have the simple emulsions and compound emulsions. So these are compounded with some additives. So suppose emulsion is nothing but it denotes the solution. You have to dilute the particular soluble oil in water, and the compound emulsions are good lubricants. They are good lubricants and coolants also, and wear resistance fluids also. So you can decrease the amount of wear by enhancing. So if you are decreasing the amount of tool wear, like the flank wear and the crater wear, you can increase the tool life. So that is the particular part you have to see. So for threading, you use the soluble oil again, and for milling, you use the compound mineral oil. Compound mineral oil, that is the sulfurized mineral oils, you have to use that. So all these are very important terms, very important oils and compounds we can suggest for different metals and machining operations. So next, for alloy steels and high carbon steel, suppose for turning, again, already we have seen, but for low carbon steels we have seen, but for alloy steels and high carbon steels, again, we can use the mineral oils or the surface oils. For milling, again, we can use the simple mineral oils or compound mineral oils. And for tapping, again, we can use the mineral oils. And for drilling, we can use the soluble oil. Because the particular material we try to drill, the particular chips or pieces will not come. So we have to use some particular force to extract that particular chips from the particular workpiece, from the drill hole. So that is that. And for cast iron, generally we use the compressed air. So we have seen in most of the particular machine shops, they try to use the compressed air from the air compressor They try to have a hose pipe, and it will be just cleaning away the chips from the drill hole like that. So brass also we use, try to use the machine dry or straight mineral oil. So aluminium, actually, we can say if we don't use a lubricant also, it is enough, because aluminium, we can just go for metal machining or metal cutting without lubricant, but sometimes we can use the kerosene oil mixed with mineral oil. Because if we use kerosene oil, you can ask why we have to use kerosene oil mixed with mineral oil. It gives good results. Because or you can use the soluble oils also. Soluble oils soluble oils are nothing but simple emulsions or conventional emulsions. So all these are the particular things you have to consider as far as the this particular cutting fluids are concerned. గోపాలకృష్ణ గారు
సార్ సార్ చెప్పండి సార్
గోపాలకృష్ణ గారు
టెల్ మీ సార్
సార్ అదే లేట్ గా జాయిన్ అవుతున్నారు కదా అడ్మిట్ చేస్తారా అండి
లేదండి నేను అడ్మిట్ చేయటం అంటే ఇప్పుడు 10:30 అదే కొంచెం బాగా ఎక్కువ లేట్ గా వచ్చిన వాళ్ళని అయితే నేను అడ్మిట్ చేసిన వాళ్ళకి అటెండెన్స్ అనేది మరి నేను అంటే ఇప్పుడు నేను ఆల్రెడీ 10:30 అలా తీసేసుకున్నా అటెండెన్స్ లేట్ అడ్మిషన్ అంటే సార్ ఇల్లు పిల్లలు కొంతమంది బై మిస్టేక్ ఏదైనా కాల్ వస్తే వాళ్ళది కట్ అయిపోతున్నాయి వాళ్ళే మళ్ళీ రీజాయిన్ అవుతున్నారు అందుకని నేను పర్మిషన్స్ ఇచ్చేస్తున్నాను రీజాయిన్ అవుతున్న వాళ్ళకి ఇబ్బంది ఏం లేదు వెయిటింగ్ అంటే వాళ్ళు బై మిస్టేక్ అది మిస్ అవుతున్నారండి కొంతమంది అది
ఓకే ఓకే టుడేస్ క్లాస్ విల్ జస్ట్ ట్రై టు వైండ్ అప్ అండ్ టుమారో విల్ జస్ట్ ట్రై టు సీ ఇఫ్ ఎనీ టాపిక్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ జస్ట్ ట్రై టు సీ ద పర్టికులర్ సిలబస్ అండ్ ట్రై టు కంప్లీట్ ఫండమెంటల్స్ ఆఫ్ మెషినింగ్ యూనిట్ 1 అలాంగ్ విత్ వర్క్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ ఐ స్టార్ట్ విత్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్ అండ్ విల్ ట్రై టు డిస్కస్ అదర్ ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ షార్ట్ ఆన్సర్స్ or how to you just want tool materials or any other part if you deemed it as difficult I'll try to again repeat that or we'll try to complete the syllabus whatever miscellaneous topic or small topics left okay we'll leave thank you one and all
thank you sir
Thank you, sir.